Hi, my name is Ian Van Tuyl. This is Aventura. It's a 2008 Hunter 41 aft cockpit. The difference between a deck salon and an aft cockpit is the cabin top is a little bit lower compared to a deck salon. So a lot of people ask that question, but I just wanted to get it out there. The aft cockpit is a lower deck profile, a little bit more traditional design. This vessel has so much gear on it, I am not going to be able to cover it in the amount of time in this video, but I will get through it, and if you look at all the specs on the listing, you're going to go see itemized of what this has on it. Thousands and thousands of dollars of upgrades on it. The owner bought this vessel new for us up in the Bay Area. It's a one-owner boat. He outfitted it up in the Bay Area, took it down to Mexico, and did cruising. It is set up for single-handed or double-handed use. And as you can see here, starting out the bow, we have a huge anchor, a really nice anchor system that's electric windlass. You're going to notice also we have a solid, all the way from the bow to the stern, a solid stainless steel rail. We have areas built in for extra additional fuel. We have a custom stainless steel kind of pulpit up here that he has two of his extra sails mounted to. And also gives you a nice area to hold on to when you're going up forward on the foredeck. We have the spinnaker pole, we have in-mast furling, there is radar with a stainless steel Riley mount at the top of the mast. This is a B&R rig, so there's 180 degrees between each point of contact, zero backstays on the vessel, something that's just well known that Hunter's been doing for quite some time. And it's not really Hunter, it's Selden Mast. So Selden's been doing this, a phenomenal layout, allows you to have a huge mainsail. Without any interference with the backstays. But as you can kind of see as we come back, we have a dodger with built-in stainless steel grab handles, a connector piece that goes up to the forward portion of the arch. That is all clear as well too. So you have full visibility of your sails. We have our stern anchor here, additional baskets here for fenders. All of this is custom stainless work, just phenomenally well done. Our outboard for the dinghy was stowed up on the cabin top here. It has a lift so you can lift it up and back. We also have a davit system that pulls out so you can bring the dinghy up at night if you desire, or have it in the back of the boat. But typically the way that owners set it up is the dinghy folded up, tied up to the front. We have a really awesome Viking life raft here with a built-in stainless steel clip bar. So you pull the quick pin, this will fall down and it deploys your life raft. The setup here with four solar panels above this custom aft stainless steel arch that you see here. We have a mounted barbecue, additional tank storage on both sides. Just phenomenal how this is all laid out. We have two storage lockers here in the back, two additional storage lockers here in the cockpit. Big, nice stern rail seats. This is an E120 Raymarine GPS plotter. We have an upgraded ST7002 Raymarine autopilot. Wind up forward above the companionways is our depth and speed. And then we also have something that's very unique. This is a Lumar bow thruster. So as I was mentioning, the vessel is really set up for single-handed use. This allows you to really operate that in any type of wind conditions. As we move through the cockpit here, the large storage locker here has been modified to accommodate the generator. The generator is down here in a soundproof shield, but you don't lose this entire storage locker. You still have a lot of space here for it. We have a VHF ram mic, also an electric cabin top winch. This is pretty unique for a 41-foot vessel. All the halyards and sheets are led back into the cockpit. And then as you can see here, we have the stereo system for the cockpit and then our other repeaters. As we come down below the vessel, you're gonna see the galley is off to the port side here. We have a large refrigerator, freezer, double stainless steel sink, a three burner stove and oven, sub storage, a full pantry, but lots of great natural light. I'm right about 6 foot, so as you can see me walking through the boat, you're gonna see I have good headroom throughout the vessel. The nav station is set up here to starboard. We have a Raymarine E80. We have our single sideband, our VHF, our generator start and stop switches, our master volt start and genset battery banks, all monitoring controls. Down below this, we have our solar boost panel. This controls the output of the solar. And then below that is our Xantrax wind generator control. So everything is really nicely done, all labeled with all the breakers, just really professional touch. One thing I can say, the vessel has a lot of equipment on it, from water makers that I'm going to show you here in a second, but a lot of stuff packed into this vessel. The salon table can be lowered to drop down into a bed. We have a sharp flat screen television, Bose. We have 12 volt fans, two here in the salon. We have an LG Blu-ray disc player, and then our Bose stereo system. As we walk up forward to the Pullman berth, you're going to see we have a sink, our Pullman bed. There's 12 volt fans, a flat screen television, and then a electric head all the way up forward in the shower compartment area. Overhead hatches, lots of natural light and ventilation through the vessel itself. Also here on the bench seat, there is a lower storage area that can pull out, so you have lots of storage in here as well. And then as we walk aft, we have our second day head. These are all Jasco quiet flush toilets. One thing that you're going to see is they've actually converted the shower stall to a storage locker, wet locker. This is where all of the filters and membranes for the water maker are. So that's been converted to this. It's just a great area. So if you're changing out filters on a water maker, all of that can drip down right into the shower sump and be pumped out. So nice use on that. This is the aft cabin. It is a Thordward ship here. We have air conditioning controls and heating controls here. We have a nice hanging locker storage. You're going to see lots of custom additions for binocular setup, additional shelving through books and what have you. There are three opening hatches, two outboard and one over, 12-volt fans. And then also this is set up for the internet as well too. So you have all your controls for your modem as well there. You're going to also notice that this has the cherry interior. 2008 was the first year that they used cherry interior with the cherry and holly subfloors. And I know we crammed a lot into this short amount of time. But if you have any questions or would like to visit this vessel or set up an appointment, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. Thank you very much. I hope you found this video to be helpful, and I look forward to talking with you soon.